Conor's coach, Coach Kavanaugh, was like, I love you, George, but there's no way that he's going to be able to eat all this food, you know, and have the weight come down. Lost like 5 pounds in the next 2 days. And he's like, I don't know what kind of black magic you got going on here, man. Hi, I'm George Lockhart.
And I'm Dan Leith, and we're the co-founders of Lockhart and Leith Nutrition, which is the largest combat sports nutrition company on the planet. The reason specifically a mixed martial artist would want to cut weight is to be the larger fighter in the octagon or in the cage. So if that means that they do need to do a drastic weight cut to be successful, we're going to be there to make sure it's done as safely as humanly possible. And if need be, it's going to be stopped. We're there to help our athlete in every way imaginable, but what our primary focus is the safety of the fighter in the moment. This was grown out of a passion for fighting ourselves. I mean, George and I were both competitive fighters. We both cut weight a significant amount throughout our lives. I started doing it as a really young kid in wrestling. I learned all the errors that there are to make. I mean, I was hospitalized as a little kid, started going into renal failure. Fast forward from there, like, I don't know, 10 years or something like that, and I met this idiot. And I was an infantryman in the Marine Corps. I got back from Afghanistan in 2010 and got selected for orders to a place called the Martial Arts Center of Excellence. And George was already there teaching nutrition. He and I hit it off right away. I mean, we got talking nutrition. We were both fighters. A lot of people say they don't believe in love at first sight, but I mean, I certainly don't love this ugly guy. Our focus is constantly improving and spreading information related to weight cutting and getting it out to our fighters.
Honestly, I think it's evolved a lot. Time flies. Over the last decade, UFC, they actually started doing something like that. They banned the IVs, they brought in USADA. People were so worried because every fighter used to get an IV after they weighed in, so they really...
What was that for?
Rehydration. They felt they needed to take an IV after they made the weight. So when they banned that, a lot of people started taking a real long look at their nutrition. They're like, man, like, I'm not gonna have the ability to take an IV anymore.
You know, we were going into rehydration, we started going into the World Health Organization's standards for oral rehydration for countries that were getting dysentery. When you go to a third world country and you have, you know, tens of thousands of people that really acute dehydration, they don't IV every single one of those people. They come up with an oral solution in bulk, and everybody drank this. And so we started looking at, like, okay, well, what are the numbers that these guys are using? How much sodium? What do they base this off?
That's literally when we started really blowing up, because people are like, oh, wow. But then people start realizing, wait, there's more than just rehydration. This actually helps increase my performance. Like, we feel better, we recover faster. There's more to this nutrition stuff. The cool thing is, a lot of people that do call us last minute, they realize what we could actually do, and then they end up working with us. Like, when I started working with Dustin Poirier, it was his first fight in the UFC. He was fighting a guy named Josh Crispy. He had to lose like 28 pounds in 21 days to get down to 145, which he never actually fought before. So what we do is a 24-hour fast. What we'll do is have them work out, let's say Friday morning, they fast for the 24 hours, and then they do another workout the next day, and then we reload them again. That does increase hormone sensitivity, cleans out the system, and helps them just drop weight too. You know, he was doing things like that. He was doing fasted cardio. We worked with him. He made the weight. He won. Now he's at 155, which is a lot better weight class for him. But that's something also that we do. Just because somebody calls us, we might tell him, like, you know, that's not the best weight for you. That's not the class that you need to be in. The kid's always been a gangster, but at the end of the day, when he was going to 145, his whole fight camp was based on him making weight. It wasn't about getting better at fighting. It was about losing the weight. The one problem that a lot of fighters make is they think, well, if I go down a weight class, I'm going to have an advantage. That's not necessarily true. When I first started fighting, I was a heavyweight. Then I went to light heavyweight, middleweight, and then I'm like, well, let's go down one more. And I ended up fighting at 170. And all my losses were at 170.
When you're at a really, really drastic cut, like the example with Dustin going to 45, so many things that you're doing on a daily basis in camp are all centered around making weight. You know, you have to be at a caloric deficit. You have to be doing additional road work. It's just, it's energy and time that you're not spending on things that you should, in my opinion, be working on with your skill coaches. The nutrition coaches should just be in the background watching what each skill coach is doing, what the strength conditioning coach is doing, and making sure that the athlete has what they need when they need it. You know, the right fuel for the moment based on what's happening in the moment in training.
Obviously, I've known Dustin for a very long time. Next thing you know, he's fighting at the interim world title at 155. He beat Max Holloway, a guy that does not let up on the gas. Like, Max Holloway, his gas tank is
for sure.
Amazing.
And that was what's so impressive to me about it, was seeing him move up to 55 and seeing just how crisp and powerful every shot was. He just looked so sharp and dialed in, and it was nice to see that like evolution of him and see him in that championship fight and look the best he's ever looked.
And, you know, again, I don't want to toot on my horn. It's like, it's not all nutrition. The cool thing is everything came together, you know? If one of those pieces was missing, like the nutrition was off or strength condition was off, there's no way he would be matched. And everything came together as a team, and he won.
Probably the fight that I worked with Daniel that was most significant was the first time I worked with him, only because that was when USADA first came into the UFC. It was the very first fight when USADA was testing all the athletes. They had banned the IV, and there was a lot of concern that, you know, because he did cut a significant amount of weight to make it to light heavyweight, everyone was a little bit afraid that he wasn't going to be able to perform the same way because he couldn't use an IV to rehydrate himself anymore.
A lot of people, weight cutting and losing weight, they put him in the same category. Losing weight takes time. To lose 1 pound, you have to be at a deficit of 3,500 calories. So if I go to a nutritionist or a dietitian, they're gonna take your BMR. This is your basal metabolic rate. This is the amount of calories that your body consumes in a given day. Then they subtract about 500 calories a day, which over the course of 7 days is a deficit of 3,500 calories. That's losing weight. Fighters actually eat more calories during fight week than they do during fight camp. Fight week, they're cutting the weight. Let's say somebody had a 10-pound cut. That means that they'd have to be at a deficit of 35,000 calories to lose that 10 pounds. Nobody eats that anyway, so even if you starve yourself, you're not gonna make that weight. What people don't realize is you need energy to actually lose the water. Everything's gotta be conducive to dropping water.
And so with Daniel, he made weight effectively, followed all of our protocols for oral rehydration. He went in and had a 5-round battle with Alexander Gustafsson, and he got better and sharper every round. He never got tired. He won the fight, I thought, in really decisive fashion. He said, man, I've never felt better. I've never felt sharper. I felt strong the whole fight. I mean, in the first 30 seconds of the fight, he went out and got a single leg on Alexander Gustafsson, who's like 6'6", something like that, yeah. And picked him up and cartwheeled him upside down across the cage. I mean, it was a validating moment to see such a great champion be able to follow all of these protocols, really do the work, and then go out and perform like he did. That was really a special moment for us.
Then we started working with Alex after the...
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, then we started working with Alex right after.
That's awesome.
Yeah. We get really close with a lot of the fighters, and then as they grow and they continue to be successful, they end up fighting one another. And so it's become like a really difficult thing for George and I, where I may know somebody really well, and George might know his opponent really well. They're both our client, and I mean, neither of us will even watch the fight. Over time, it's just become harder and harder the closer you get with your fighters. We spend more time with our athlete than any other person. You feel like kind of like a dad, like a parent almost, you know. It's like, yeah, driving to practice, you have your gloves, like get their water, you know, make sure they're going to bed on time, trying to make things as easy as possible so they can just focus on eating, sleeping, training.
If you're stressed out, your body's not going to release water. So the more stressed you are, the more you're going to hold on to. So we try to make their life as cool and relaxed as possible. When I first started working with Conor, it was the Jose Aldo fight. We create programs around the person. So what I asked, I'm like, hey, what is Conor doing every day? What's his age? What's his height? What's his weight? What's his activity levels? How many times is he working out? And then we filled out a program. We wrote up the program for him. And I was giving him everything that he needed based on his activities, age, and everything else. So I didn't know what he was having before. Obviously, he wasn't eating a whole lot. I think he was only eating like once or twice a day, whereas the meal that I gave him, I think it was like 7 times a day. And his coach, Coach Kavanaugh, was like, I love you, George, but there's no way that he's gonna be able to eat all this food, you know, and have the weight come down. So he started following the program, lost like 5 pounds in the next 2 days, and he's like, I don't know what kind of black magic you got going on here, man. A lot of people say like a calorie is a calorie, which not necessarily true. Every food that you eat actually creates or needs a specific amount of energy to break it down. Almost 40% of protein is actually used in the digestion of protein. So what that's called is the thermogenic effect of foods. The more calories a food needs to be digested, the higher the thermogenic effect. So what we do is we take that into account. Because remember, we never want to take calories away from somebody because calories are a measurement of energy. So I don't want to take energy away from you. I just need to switch up the macronutrients. The program will do that for that individual. They don't lose weight. It increases the amount of protein. It doesn't change the caloric intake. It just changes the macronutrient makeup. The thermogenic effect of foods kicks in and they lose weight.
We've been really lucky. You know, we've been exposed to so many athletes since we started doing this. And when we were talking about doing this back in the Marine Corps, I mean, we had no idea where we were going to end up and the experiences we were going to have, the fighters we were going to get an opportunity to work with. I mean, at this point, we've worked with, I mean, almost every champion that's been in the UFC over the last, eight years, yeah. And we've transcended MMA into boxing now, getting to work with Badu Jack and Triple G. I mean, I got an opportunity to work for a year with Demi Lovato. I get to do it every day with my best friend. I mean, all kidding aside, I really don't like looking at George that much, but he's my best friend in the world, and I got to build this alongside him.
We're only two guys, though. You know, in the United States alone, there's 25,000 MMA gyms. In the United States. So what we did is we started a certification process, and we have a bunch of people that are basically starting their own companies based on the system that we've taught them. We go all over the world and we teach people how to safely cut weight. The amateur guys at the bottom of the barrel, they can get the same coaching, same system as the Conor McGregor's and the Triple G's in the world.
I would say to anybody that's watching this that does cut weight, I mean, do yourself a favor and spend the time and money finding a coach who has trained in this, has been through one of our certifications, or has trained in this somewhere else. Taking it on yourself, following old school methods, it's a quick way to get hurt really fast.